Welcome to the Hooters. You're speaking with Athena. How can I help you? How much do I know about the event? Like, absolutely nothing. I've heard like there's like some spicy dialogue between Ying'er and Timaeus, and I am so like, I'm so for this. I'm so keen to hear this dialogue, this spicy dialogue.
Hey there. We're looking for the elixir artificer of Chihu Rock. Would you know where he lives?
I'm sorry, but I'm not very familiar with the nicknames that my neighbors have. Perhaps you could ask Ying'er from Scent of Spring.
Oh yeah, that makes sense. Miss Ying'er should totally be familiar with what's going on around here. Let's just go ask her.
Alright, consult Ying'er. This is the part I am looking forward to the most. I'm gonna give Ying'er the most seductive female voice I can possibly muster. Because I need this to happen.
Oh, so glad to see that I'm finally on your mind. And you brought a friend too. Here to keep me company, perhaps.
Oh boy, Paimon's got a funny feeling about this already. Actually, Miss Ying'er, we're here to pay the Elixir Artificer a visit. Do you know where we can find this person?
Oh my, you've got your foot in another boat already, I see. I must admit, I am a little disappointed. Ara ara. But I must say that it's a pleasant surprise that you're digging into my deepest secrets like this.
Secrets?
Wait a minute. Does this mean that Miss Ying'er is the elixir artificer?
Growing ever smarter, I see. How adorable.
That's unexpected.
To think that the elixir artificer would be so young and so beautiful. Sure.
Guys, I feel like the third wheel.
Sure, the feeling is quite different from Mr. Albedo, but there's that same inscrutable aura. Looking at your flustered faces, you must have some cares that need lifting. Come now, let's be direct, shall we?
Paimon feels like this situation is about to take an unexpected turn.
Yeah, no shit.
Ah, so this alchemist is doing research into this wondrous smoldersleet elixir. I'm afraid that I'm about to disappoint you. The smoldersleet elixir you seek is just an ancient perfume that is my specialty. It has nothing to do with alchemy.
A perfume? Isn't that some sort of solid spice? Old spice? Is this a reference to old spice?
But it has such a cool name, and the book said that it could make people stronger.
I suspect that must have been the result of the perfume's popularity. The ancient writers once emphasized the virtues of edification through immersion. That is to say that human temperament and character can be affected by being steeped in aromas and lovely scents. Those who have used my ancient perfume find themselves becoming magnetic, confident, their relations ever improving, their careers ever climbing, their sailing ever smooth. Why, it's almost as if they had truly used an adepti elixir. As such, people gave that ancient perfume of mine a suitably poetic name before writing a simple poem to praise its efficacy.
So that's how it is!
That can't be. Was the essay I read mistaken, or was my understanding of the poem an error? Like, for example, this elixir is said to reinvoke the radiant dignity within. Doesn't that mean that it's capable of unlocking a person's inner power and potential, Miss Ying'er?
Oh dear. Actually, this phrase refers to a person's demeanor and temperament. What it really means is that the ancient perfume allows people to appear refreshed and radiant.
So, word-by-word analysis doesn't work in this case? But that book mentioned many of the curious effects of the smoldersleet elixir. Honestly, I was left speechless as I read them.
Titillating. Of course they're using this word. Titillating mysteries are fascinating things, like a lovely silhouette seen through a window screen. So too, do books that record street rumors require a certain artistic license. Ah, but I must say, that really was high praise.
How could this be?
So let Paimon get this straight. Timaeus' reference material bragged about the perfume's effects, and then he misread the poem, resulting in his believing that Smoldersleet Elixir is some super powerful alchemical medicine?
Well, can't say I didn't come mentally prepared.
So, in the end, my research was based on incorrect arguments. Oh, I failed again.
Now, don't get so down. They do say that the path between mountains leads to new trails, and even the withered wood shall sprout anew. Perhaps the ancient arts of producing perfume might give you a little inspiration and allow you to break through this final bottleneck in producing the medicine you desire.
That's true. Things might have developed weirdly, but you did get pretty far using your own understanding, Timaeus. Since Miss Ying has agreed to help, why not give it a go?
Who knows, you might make some unexpected gains. Now, the making of ancient perfumes is quite the delicate process. Think of your movements as a lover's caress. Gently peel the bud open. Remove the petals and stack them with care. Thinner petals on top, thicker ones below. Leaving appropriate gaps between each, then mash them.
Just reading the sentence and then the fact that I'm gonna say it out loud. Oh god, this is too good. Oh my god! Help! I've lost the plot! Help! This broke me.
Don't grip your mortar and pestle too tightly. Loose wrists, steady rhythm, up and down, up and down.
Oh my god. Oh.
Up and down, up and down. Wait until the petal sap has...
It keeps getting worse and worse.
Wait until the petal sap has oozed out and the base of your mortar and pestle are moist before speeding up.
Oh my god. Miss Ying'er, I must say that your choice of words is most, unique. Nonetheless, I understand what you mean. The raw materials must be handled carefully and placed into the container in the right order. The timing of immersing them into the base fluid must be precise so that we can better control the temperature.
Ah, you're quite the right spark, aren't you? But that's not all. The sublimation effect of certain perfumes must be given utmost care. As such, suitably auxiliary materials such as mint and star conch must be added. This way, the perfume scent will diffuse quickly, allowing everyone around to relax. But this effect cannot be too strong, or the perfume will not endure long.
Sublimate, you say? I get it. Actually, this aspect of making ancient perfumes is exactly what I'm looking for. I don't know what that word is. Aerosolized medication can affect both the user and the environment, granting them more obvious effects than ordinary essential oils. Fine control over the sublimation speeds should allow such agents to last longer than essential oils as well. Yes, this direction is very promising indeed.
Wow, there's no place in this academic mumbo jumbo for the likes of us, huh?
Nope, we are definitely third and fourth wheeling here, Paimon.
Let's leave them alone for a while, shall we?
Paimon gets it.
good, Paimon.
It smells great! Paimon feels refreshed and energized already!
It really does perk you up.
I finally succeeded in combining ancient perfume making with alchemical agents. Thank you so much, Miss Ying'er. If not for your expert instruction, there's no way I would have grasped these concepts and made these medicines so easily.
Oh, come now. Too much humility will make you come off as shallow and overly polite. It was your own knowledge and discernment that proved key to your success. Well then, won't you give the fruit of your ardent labor a name?
Let's call them Smolder Sleep Potions then. They're a combination of your perfume-making techniques and the features of alchemical potions together. A unique blend that will go down in history for sure!
Oh my, how you flatter me. But, you know, that name's not all that different from Smolder Sleep Elixir.
Well, let's get back on topic. Traveler, as promised, you shall be the very first user of the Smolder Sleep Potion. It could still use some improvement in its current form, so could I trouble you to test its effects for me? Its effects should be more obvious in areas where the airflow is gentle. I've heard that Liyue has some domains in which no one sets foot. I reckon these would be ideal testing grounds. Honestly, you've got me pretty excited too. Then you have my thanks. I'll remain here for a while, of course you will. I'll remain here for a while longer to continue my discussions with Miss Ying'er. Once I get your feedback, I'll make some improvements to the Smolder Sleep Potion.
We'll be waiting for good news from you. There's still a lot more to learn in the fields of perfumes and essential oils. Would you like to hear it?
Of course! In fact, we could keep going for days and nights on... Of course they could. As long as you don't mind, of course.
Oh, Ying'er, I want to hear more Ying'er.
It's just as you predicted, Miss Ying'er. Our path for improvement is clear. We must somehow contain the sublimated substances within a set area. Perhaps we could reverse the special characteristics of dandelions to create special excipients that can prevent the substances from being affected by the flow of air. There is no precedent to such a method, though, and we will need a great number of trials to prove its feasibility.
Wow, Paimon couldn't make sense of that at all. Still, it feels like you made some important suggestions each time, Miss Ying'er.
I don't think I ever came up with such a detailed postulation. Well, my hard-working alchemist. Are you trying to fathom my depths, or are you just trying to please me through flattery?
I'm just expressing my admiration for your knowledge.
All right. You'd best give it your all now. Who knows? You might have to use some alternative sources of knowledge in the future, too. Don't forget to keep me posted once your research succeeds.
Not gonna lie, voicing Ying'er has been my favorite to this day. Of course! When the time comes, I'll send you my best potions as memento. You know, Miss Ying'er, if you have time, would you like to come with us to Wonmin Restaurant?
Oh, I'm afraid our academic exchange must come to an end for now. There are still many matters I must attend to at Scent of Spring. Don't forget to drop by often.
We will. Thanks, Miss Ying'er.
Oh, I couldn't say it in the end, huh?
But considering that I'd already given her so much trouble, it was probably for the best I didn't take up any more of her time. All right then, we'll calm down a bit and wait for a more suitable opportunity.
What are you talking to yourself about, Timaeus?
Nothing. Thanks for your help so far. As we agreed, I'll treat you both to a great meal at Wonmin Restaurant. I'd almost forgotten.
Oh, that's right. All right. Time for a great big meal. Ooh, Paimon's super full. Actually, this research was pretty cool. You should bring us along next time you come to Liyue, Timaeus.
You know, Paimon, somehow I doubt that you're in it for the research.
Oh, come on! Paimon did help! Ask for directions?
Whatever the case, thank you both so much. But once I return to Mondstadt, I'll be throwing myself into improving the Smolder Sleep Potion, so I'm afraid I won't be coming back to Liyue for some time. Maybe I'll have to ask you to help me deliver a letter. I mean, I still haven't properly thanked Miss Ying'er for her help. Oh, these two, man.
Huh? Weren't you two discussing stuff the whole time? Why didn't you just tell her?
Well, Miss Ying'er's speech, manner of speech, is too special. I must consider my words very carefully, and in such cases, penning a letter is naturally superior to speaking face to face. Well, now, time presses. Let's head back to Mondstadt right now. Why, I can't wait to create the perfected version of my Smolder Sleep Potion.
Traveler, do you get the feeling that Timaeus has been acting all weird ever since we said bye to Miss Ying'er? Paimon doesn't get it. Tell her how you feel, man.
All right, let's do it.